I still have dreams where it's like we're in the store building somehow, still selling stuff when we should have been closed, you know, like a month before, and we were open secretly, still selling things. So to have that, you know, still there, it hangs over that we had a really great time, and I thought a pretty good presence in the community, even if we weren't doing the kind of business, I guess, that we should have been doing.
I thought it was fairly healthy, to be honest. But, you know, sometimes what you see isn't what other people see.
You'd go there and then they would just like have less and less stuff until the very end when all of the walls were just bare and they were just like, just take this stuff. Here, here's your discounts. In my first year of college, which I think that it shut down pretty towards the end of it, actually. But yep, I spent an embarrassing amount of money there. I probably went when I first discovered it, probably went every few days. Definitely, at least always bought one album. That's a lot of money to be throwing down.
I worked there in the 90s from about 95 to 98. Then I went on to pursue some other ventures after I graduated from college. Ended up doing a number of other jobs, and when we adopted our first child, I found that it was probably easiest if I worked a part-time job. And the fetus actually asked me back, and that would have been around 2011 until they closed.
You know, one thing that was always interesting is you could almost tell going in the door who was working there by what was playing on the stereo in there. And I always tried to make a point of going in the back door, because if Andy was there, you know, he'd usually work at that back desk. And we'd shoot the breeze about something. Andy's a big baseball guy too, as am I. So we would have that to talk about, if not music. But I always liked going in when he was there, because he had a pretty good feel on it for what kind of stuff I usually like and was looking for. And that's again something that you don't get online. You don't get, you know, at a box store or anything like that. You know, you probably get turned on to some stuff that you would not otherwise have ever heard or paid any attention to.
It was one of the first places I went as a freshman, and I knew about it. My parents actually went to school here too, and just kind of being what people might refer to as an audiophile, or, you know, musician, and always into music. You know, new CD comes out, we just walk over to Electric Fetus, and is literally was part of why I chose St. Cloud to stay and be part of the community. They had everything, including an independent record store where you could go pick up stuff that you're not going to get anywhere else.
I had spent so much time going there. I mean, I kind of managed to wean myself back a little bit, but like, it was still just a fun place to go to and to just be there. Like, you could always count on going there and hearing new music, finding new things, talking to cool, interesting people.
The last 2 months that we were together were actually some of the best months that we had. And it was like we wanted to drag every good idea that each of us had into those months. We came together as a staff. We were deeply emotional. Had a great toast at the end on the last day. The last day was insane. The music that we had and the support that we had from the community. It was a love fest, and the staff loved each other, and the folks that came out to support, some of them came out Johnny Come Latelys, why wasn't I here for the last 2 years, that kind of thing. But in the big picture, it was actually a pretty well loved and in fact now missed business in the St. Cloud community.
It's significantly changing the identity of downtown, because that corner was full of independent, locally owned businesses and music. You had the Pioneer Place, locally owned and operated, D.B. Searles, locally owned and operated, Red Carpet, locally owned and operated, and on the corner you had the Electric Fetus. It was like the gateway into this really unique music scene we have had. It's got a lot of changes, and even the press. I think I played in bands that played at the press, D.B.'s, Red Carpet, what used to be the Rocks. When that went away too, it was kind of like, my gosh, another place for independent music was thriving, it's disappeared. Personally, I think we've already started to flood the market with these craft beer kind of burger restaurants, and I worry about whether they will succeed downtown or not.
Well, the ramp's still the same. See that like ramp in that hall? I mean, that ramp was like that in the store, and they had the CD racks on each side.
You're going to see reflections of yourself.
A little bit.
If it came down to walking through the doors, I think it would rush over me too much. And I don't think that I would have a very positive experience, especially to think that it's now a franchise burger and beer place. That's not what I think of that location. I mean, going back to my first quarter at college, I was buying records in it, and it had a funky feel, ambiance, smell, you know, whatever you want to say, but the Fetus had a magic of its own, and I'm sure that whatever they did to make it look acceptable now, they'd never have done to the store when it was in business as a record store. So, you know, it just seems a little bit false, and, you know, I don't have a particularly high opinion of going in and supporting that business.
So, what was it like in there?
Huh?
What was it like in there?
Oh my god, you're a
burger. I am.
Well, felt like another bar, and to add to a constant string of bars that St. Cloud has. It's pretty, but it's not as good as it used to be.
You know, opening a record store isn't just, you know, finding a building and throwing a bunch of records in it.
I think it's going to take a really more of a corporate investment rather than a personal investment to make a record store ever, you know, come back to St. Cloud in an independent way.
So the IMCCM, the Independent Music Collaboration of Central Minnesota, kind of came out of the online Facebook discussion of who would support an independent music store in St. Cloud. That's part of what founded the Independent Music Collaboration of Central Minnesota.
What I found was that they identified a lot more of other things that we need in St. Cloud, like, you know, more local venues, and all of a sudden the Pickled Loon, you know, sprouts up, and, you know, they've been a savior to this town.
Right now, our goal is just kind of helping organize folks who want to get into the scene, connecting them with peers and resources. You know, my long-term goal, part of the organization, is to have a place like that where we can do that. We have an actual location. It could be as simple as something like the Electric Fetus, or maybe we bring back something like the Java Joint or Java Z, where you can do all ages shows. And we need that. The community needs that. The kids here need that. A lot of youth-oriented stuff. Bottom line is, we have an amazing music scene here. and so much opportunity to show that to the rest of the state and nation. And I think the organization that came out of the closing of Electric Fetus could be one of those, you know, you turn a bad thing into an amazing thing. So it really sparked a really cool mission that I think is gonna do a lot of good for St. Cloud.